It's 1960 and this is PDP-1, the first commercial computer designed around interaction with a human operator. It costs more than $100,000 and has no monitor. You have to use a device initially invented for telegraphy, a teleprinter for both input and output. You type the command and the computer literally prints back the response on paper. And yes, it appears that you can do a lot with teleprinters. People programmed entire operating systems with them. And as you can imagine, you need a special kind of a text editor here, the super focused one. There is no user interface, no copy-paste, no cursor movement, nothing at all. Just you and the current line you are working on. You need to think about each edit you are going to perform before doing that. If you make a mistake, the editor just shows you a question mark. Absolutely ruthless. So, if you want to try the ultra-violence text editing level by yourself, you can run the add command. The general principle is this: you type a command that is applied to current line or a range of lines in a text file. First, I will install add. Let me start this bad boy. This number shows the total number of characters in the file I've just opened. By default, the editor is positioned at the last line. Let's print it out. Dot is the range, it means exactly that, current line. This is how I can print my whole file. The range here is the address of the first line, a comma, and the address of the last line, inclusive. By the way, I can do crazy things with ranges. Let me show you. First, I would move to line 6. Now, with this command, I can check surrounding lines, 3 lines above and 3 lines below. After the range, I have a command, P, for print in this case. I can actually omit the starting and finishing line addresses altogether to get all the lines in the file. If I put N instead of a P, I get lines printed with their line numbers. Hey, I said it's an actual editor. I can search for lines. This will find just the next line matching the regular expression. If I want, however, to get all the matching lines, I have to put G in front of the slash. By the way, this is where the name of the grep tool comes from. I'll tell you more. The code for original version of grep was extracted directly from the add. Of course, if I can search, I can do replace as well. Let's check the result. Now I want to find all dependencies of this project, package names with their versions. How about I replace all words poetry in this file with prose? I need to do the search using the comma all lines range, and I should also not forget about G to replace all substrings found, not just the first one. Okay, let's check. Let's do something more interesting. I want to add a copyright header to the file. This gets the output of a command appended to my open file. Note escaping the percent sign. At this point, all the changes to the file I've opened are only stored in memory. To write them to disk, I need to run a separate command. If I omit a file name here, changes will be saved to the open file. The most important command, exiting the editor. Now, how about I just put all these commands for my copyright line to a script? I can run these commands like a script now. And here is the result. You can probably guess, these are the tools directly inspired by line editors like Ed. So in addition to having fun being godlike in text editing and impressing your teammates, learning some Ed will help you to become more efficient with Vi, or Vim, or nvim. And by the way, there is a line editor available for DOS as well, it's called Edlin. Check out the channel description to find the link to all the code snippets you've seen in this episode.